agro-based industries, industries which are obtained their raw material from agriculture. Agriculture, in which as of us as a cotton textiles, as we discussed yesterday, cotton textiles are widely concentrated towards as the western parts of our country. Gujarat, Maharashtra, and Madhya Pradesh are the favorable conditions, providing as a favorable conditions for location of a cotton textiles. Location of cotton textiles. The cotton textiles in such parts generally as a growing at the time of a British age, when the first cotton textile industry of India, it was as located at Bombay in 1854. Cotton textiles, well known in during as a British age, because at that time the large number of Indian cotton high demanded in European countries like as a calico, bandana, chintz, muslin, jamdani, such kind of a categories of cotton clothes highly demanded in European countries. Demanded in European countries. Their goods were demanded in European countries. Earlier as a Britishers, they directly exported as a raw cotton towards as a European countries, but later in stage, to the re-industrialization, they set up as a small scale units, small scale manufacturing units, which were known for the processes of a ginning and a spinning purposes. Afterwards, a spinning of a yarn, such material exported towards as a England for manufacturing of a cotton clothes, for which as a material directly as exported towards the England for a manufacturing of a cotton clothes, weaving and a dyeing purposes, for which as a cotton manufacturing of a fabric yarn was exporting towards the England. During as a historical background, the Indian weavers produce as a quality products by the hand spinning and the looms. After the Industrial Revolution, power looms and machines, power loom and machines were introduced. This gave a boost to the indigenous textile industries, throwing the thousands of weavers out of the work, as mill made cloth from England was cheaper and better. India's first successful modern cotton mill, it was as a set up at Bombay in 1854 by the efforts of Britishers. Britishers as contributing for a growth of a first cotton textile at Bombay in 1854 by the Parsi entrepreneurs. At that time, as the Swadeshi movement, which was as a started by the Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhi, Swadeshi movement, in which as a Gandhiji preferred for a Indian made goods or clothes, which were as a manufactured by the Indian weavers during as a 20th century, the time period of two world wars, as does boost for a local and traditional weaving industry. At present, there are the 1600 cotton and synthetic fiber industries are located at present in our country. Cotton textile is the largest organized modern industry of India, mostly located in Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, and western parts of Madhya Pradesh. The factors which are affecting as a growth of a cotton textiles in such states as, first, the availability of a raw cotton from available black soil regions of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, supportive for the location of a cotton textiles in western parts of a country. Factors affecting as a growth of a cotton textiles in western parts of a country. The first, as a availability of a black soil supportive for a production of a raw cotton. Second, the coastal climatic conditions, hot and humid weather conditions of nearness of a Arabian coast supportive for a growth of a more cotton textiles. Why? Because due to as a humid weather conditions, due to the humid weather conditions, it strengthens the thread. That's why as a cotton textiles are concentrated towards as the coastal regions. Humid climate aided the weaving, but today in a high-tech environment, this factor has lost in the significance of a humid weather conditions. Artificially, as a humid weather conditions are providing to the cotton textiles, due to as a large number of a population which is living in a parts of a Maharashtra, adjoining parts of a Bombay, in Maharashtra, Gujarat, supportive for the availability of a skilled and unskilled both type of a workforce, which is also supportive for the growth of a cotton textiles at the western parts of a country. Bombay is known as the financial capital because of a location of a share market. It is known as the financial capital. Delhi is the political capital. Bombay is the financial capital, which is as providing as the banking and credit facilities for location of a large number of a small scale and large scale cotton textiles. One of the biggest advantages has been accessibility to the Southwest Asia and European markets to the port cities on a western coastal plains as a Mumbai, Kandla, Kochi ports, Mangalore ports are supportive for growth of a cotton textiles. After the manufacturing of a cotton clothes, these are easily sending towards the European and African countries. Next, as a supply of electricity for a cotton textiles, it has supplied to the existence of a Sardar Sarovar Dam, the dam built on Narmada River. Due to as a large number of a population, afterwards a manufactured clothes, they can as easily consumed in a local markets also. Large population supportive for a consumption of such material, such cotton clothes which manufactured in a cotton textiles of Western India, easily as a water available, the windward sides of a Western Ghats receiving as a plenty of rain during June, July, August and September through the southwest monsoon winds, which is also a reason considered as the location of a cotton textiles at the western parts of country. Mumbai or Ahmedabad as situated on east-west corridor. This is as a transition center of a east-west corridor. About the corridors we will discuss in the next chapter. It is as a transitional center of a east-west corridor. Due to as this, it has cover under the four-lane routes, the Grand Trunk Routes. Efficient network of a roadways and a railway network combined with the accessibility to the ports of a Mumbai, Chennai, Kochi, Surat, Kandla, Mangalore, etc. Due to as the availability of a road and a railways, growth of roads and railways, which are supportive for the export of materials towards other nations through the accessibility towards the ports of Mumbai, Chennai, Kandla, Kochi and Surat. Cotton textiles are generally work in three systems in our country. Mill sector, power loom, and handloom industry. handloom industry. Cotton textiles are generally worked through as the three systems: mill sector, power loom, and handloom industry. Mill sector is a dead part of a cotton textiles, in which different processes associated with the manufacturing, handled by the industries. For example, on your screens, there are some of the activities are there. Raw fiber, the ginning process has done by the one mill. Second, as a spinning process will done by the another mill. Third, as a weaving sector also. So separately, as a different stages associated with the manufacturing, of a materials or a transformation of a raw material into the usable items. Has done in an industry. Different processes associated with the transformation of raw material into the usable items. For example, ginning, spinning as a separately handled by the different industries. Such industries are small scale manufacturing units are the cover under the mill sector. Mill sector is a responsible for the managing of a such kind of the activities as the separately. Clear? So one as the mill sector. Second, power loom industry. Power loom industry is a that part of a cotton textiles which are handled, which are concerned about the directly transformation of a raw material into the finished goods. Means the raw cotton used in a such large scale cotton textiles with the use of a machinery, with the use of modern machinery, these industries, they transform the raw material into the usable items. Means raw cotton used by the such industries afterwards through industry as a shirt selling in a market. They are not associated with a different manufacturing. All the manufacturing processes are occurred in the same place. Of a power loom. Third, as a handloom industry. Handloom industry is associated with the those weavers which are manufacture cotton clothes through traditional skills, means weavers. Cotton clothes at their homes. So that handloom industry has presently covered under the Khadi Bhandar Udyog. Such industries which are known for manufacturing of cotton clothes through weavers now as covered under the Khadi Bhandar Udyog. In rural economy, such are the cooperative societies which are supportive towards the weavers. Khadi Bhandar Udyog. Clear? Till there any questions? Khadi Bhandar Udyog. This cotton textiles provided a diverse forms of employment to a large number of people, from growing cotton to picking cotton, ginning, spinning, weaving, bleaching, dyeing, designing, tailoring, in a different forms. Cotton textiles Cotton textiles provided the diverse forms of employment. For example, first, growing cotton to farmers. Second, as a picking cotton, picking the cotton balls from a cotton shrub. Once the sowing of a cotton plant, it is capable for a harvest for a two consecutive years. So second, as a laborers, it has given the jobs to the laborers, to those laborers which are picking the cotton balls from the cotton shrubs. Third, gaining separation of our cotton seeds from cotton balls. Gaining. Fourth, as a spinning, in which as a cotton balls transform into the yarn thread. Fifth, as the weaving, transformation of a thread into the fabric. Transformation of thread into fabric. Sixth, as a bleaching or dyeing, coloring of a fabric into a different colors. Seventh, as a designing, cutting of a fabric, such colored dyed cotton clothes into the different purposes for the shirts, pants, trousers, then afterwards as a tailoring. The other industries are dependent on a textiles have developed as a chemicals. Remember at the beginning we discussed as a urban agglomeration economies. Due to the cotton textiles, growth of our cotton textiles, what kind of the industries which are developing chemicals and the dyes, industries which are manufacturing as a dyes or a chemicals for dyeing the cotton clothes, coloring the cotton clothes, printing equipments, tailoring and stitching machines, needles, scissors, pins, etc. So these industries are supportively grow due to as influence of a cotton textiles. Due to the growth of cotton textiles, chemical industry, dyers, printing equipments, stitching, tailoring, needlework, scissors, manufacturing of scissors, etc. are also developing. They are also developing with support of a cotton textile industries. Spinning of a high quality yarn is in the mill sector, which is centralized sector located in a, it is the centralized sector located mainly in a Maharashtra, Gujarat and Tamil Nadu. Weaving is in decentralized sector. It provides scope to the incorporate traditional skills and design of weaving in cotton, zari, embroidery, zari as a, for example, in a Punjab, there is as a type of a cotton cloth, which is as a very famous as fulkari, zari, embroidery, etc. Quality of a weaving is not world class, is decentralized sector. The decentralized sector is very important part of a rural economy. It provides large scale of employment to those underdeveloped areas of a rural economy, which earlier known for a production of a cotton. Now, due to as a growth of a cotton in a large scale, people in rural economy, they are setting up their own small scale agro-based manufacturing units due to the support of cooperatives. Gandhiji laid the emphasis on the growth of handspun yarn, khadi. Gandhi ji paid their emphasis towards as the khadi, use of a khadi in India before of independence of our country. As according to the Gandhi ji, he thought that only as a, with the use of a khadi, we can support towards the Indian economy, to the Indian economy. So we must encourage power loom and the handloom sector for their employment potential. It will reduce as a burden of a disguised unemployed in a agricultural sector if we increase the number of a handloom industries and a power loom industries in our country. India exports yarn to the Japan, thread yarn to Japan, and other importers of cotton goods from India are the US, United States of America, United Kingdom, East and Central European countries, France, Russia, Singapore, and Nepal. Nepal, African and Southeastern Asian countries. India is the second largest. India has possessed the second largest capacity of spindles producing the 25% of world's high quality yarn after China. India is the second largest producer of yarn in a world economy, which constitutes as 25% in a world's total production of yarn afterwards the China. After China, India, it produced the 25% of a total yarn production as compared to the world. It contributes a 25% in a total production of yarn, which is as a second largest country afterwards China. But the trade of our garments is only as a 4%. We are here exporting as a raw yarn to the other economies. If we increase our garments towards as other countries, then it will be as a more profitable comparatively the export of a yarn. Due to as a export of a quality yarn, we cannot use in weaving and knitting much except supplied from fragmented smaller units. But the need of our is to reduce the export of yarn and enhance the exports of woven and ready-made garments to the other countries of the world. Clear? Other countries of the world. Next are the problems associated with the cotton textiles in India. What are the problems associated with the cotton textiles in India? First, as an erratic power supply. Second, lower productivity of labor, erratic power supply, shortage of a supply of a power as compared to the demand. Third, outdated machinery, Machindi is an old traditional which was as a late in a 60, 70 years back. That's why as a low production as a occur, such machinery needs to be as upgraded to reduce the cost of production. Next, fourth is a strict competition with the synthetic fiber. Cotton textile industry facing as a strict competition with the synthetic fiber. Fifth, shortage of raw material, a large number of yarn directly exporting towards the other countries, yarn exporting towards the other countries, because of which as the deficiency of raw material is a basic problem for manufacturing of growth of a cotton textiles in India. These factors result in a loss to the mills. Present competitive scenario requires total upgradation of mills and processing technology, and emphasis on the exports of finished goods rather than the raw materials. We have to increase the emphasis over the export of finished goods, finished cotton clothes or garments towards as other countries as compared to the raw yarn. As compared to the thread, we have to export the fabric or garments towards the world economies, to which we can earn as a more profit margin comparatively the export of raw materials. Clear? Till there any questions? Yes, 10th B class. Any questions? Next are the jute industries. Next, agro-based industry as a jute industry. Jute is the another important agro-based industry which needs as a raw material, which obtain their raw material from the agricultural sector. India's first jute mill, it was as a setup at a Rishra near Kolkata in 1855. On 1855, Rishra, India's first jute mill established. Cotton textile mill set up at Bombay in 1854. Rishra, 1855, as a first jute mill set up during as a British age. It stands the next to the cotton textile in importance. India is the largest producer of raw jute and second largest exporter of jute goods. In an agriculture chapter, we discuss as a diversified forms of goods are produced from a jute like mat, sacks, S-A-C-K-S, mats, sacks. Jute also used for manufacturing of clothes. Jute also used for manufacturing of clothes, mats, sacks, bags, etc. Ropes for which as a jute require. Jute, India is the leading producer of jute, largest producer of jute, and second largest producer and exporter of jute goods in a world market afterwards the Bangladesh after the partition of a country on a 1947, India becomes as the second largest producer. Before 1947, India was a leading producer of jute in a world economy due to its tropical, hot, humid weather conditions of eastern parts of country. West Bengal is the major producer of jute in India. Mills are located along the banks of Hooghly River. Jute mills are concentrated around the Hooghly River, which is a distributary of Ganga, Hooghly, in a narrow belt of 98 kilometers of a surface area of Hooghly Basin has covered under the jute mills, which account for the maximum mills. Around 70 mills are located in this region. 70 mills are located in this region of a Hooghly Basin of West Bengal. The factors affecting asset location of jute industries in eastern parts of a country are close proximity of mills to jute growing areas, proximity of the jute producing areas. In this region of eastern India, parts of West Bengal, Assam, Bihar, Meghalaya, Odisha, these are the rich in alluvial soils. Deltaic soils are favorable for a production of jute. Deltaic regions of West Bengal and Odisha favorable for production of jute at hot humid weather conditions. So that's why as the jute industries are concentrated towards West Bengal. Second reason, abundant water available for raw jute. Inexpensive, the cheapest mode of transportation to the river. Inland waterway of India, India's longest inland waterway from Allahabad to Hooghly River on Ganga. It has supported for a growth of jute industries in West Bengal. Nearness of Kolkata port supportive for a growth of jute industries through which it easily exported towards the other countries of world due to as a dense growth of vegetation. Dense growth of population in parts of West Bengal supportive to provide cheap labor for jute industries, inexpensive and skilled laborers from densely populated areas of West Bengal, adjoining Odisha, Jharkhand, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, supportive for the growth of jute industries. Next, as abundant Abundant infrastructure facilities like banking, insurance, finance, power supply, support of good rail and roadway network. It supported the growth of jute industries in the eastern parts of a country. Next reason, vast national and international market for jute products. Supportive for a growth of a jute industries in a eastern parts of country. Jute industry is important as it provides support to approximately 2.6 lakhs workers. 2.6 lakhs workers and another as a 40 lakh small and a marginal farmers with small land holdings producing the raw jute and local variety of a jute named as a mesta, M-E-S-T-A. Production of a jute named as the mesta. Clear? So rest we will discuss on a next class.